Can you guys hear me now? This thing is huge. Hey, sorry about that. I've been sitting here talking for no reason. Alright. Super sorry about that technical retardation. So I'm planning to do a run with Verdi lead and a run with Perna lead. See what the difference is. A lot of the monsters on here are not full skilled, like some of the key ones, Belusual, Teor, being my damage dealer. Also, not being full skilled would be a big help. Like I said, while I was apparently muted, I've been on a crazy luck spree. I pulled like 24 Nat 5s in 3 months, so I have a lot of units that are just not maxed out all the way. Skill-wise, it's going to take me a while. I need like 300-something devil mons. No big deal. They make it really easy to get, right? So 134 with the Verdi lead. The team idea is I'm using Belusual. Hey! Not only as a as an immunity, but I'm also using him for a stripper. Archangels with a 75% on skill 1 is pretty nice. The fact that I also don't have a lot of skill ups means it's less likely for him to use skill 2. Increasing the chance of me getting that immunity buff removed on the boss. Therefore, I can lay into him before he can lay into me, right? This is with that Perna lead. So, Belusual goes first to make sure I have that immunity going on my team versus the dragon, also to ensure that he's pulling the buff off of the dragon so that I can lay more damage into him. More efficiently. After that, obviously put Galleon for the defense break, increase your damage throughout your damage dealing turns. Biggest thing is getting your defense break on this dragon in this floor right there. I'm gonna lose Teor. If you get that off early, then Teor wouldn't have died. But also, if you get the defense break on the middle monster, no matter which one it is, and you don't have it landed on the monsters with the smaller HP, your units are going to attack the middle monster more so. So, the higher accuracy on Galleon increases the chance that you're going to get your... Oh, not today. Tarka Kali's an option. I've actually got my 56-second time on here using a Kali and Tark team. Just kind of messing around, trying to see what I can do with... the no skills on the higher up units, the Nat 5s. Been able to keep my times pretty stable around 130 to 2 minutes. Sometimes it goes down to 115-ish. Using those monsters, I need to buff up HP a little bit. I can do a run and show you what that's like. I have pretty mediocre runes as of right now on units that I'm not using too much, Kali being one of them. Tarka, I've okay runes on, I'll show you. I'd like to make him violent. He's currently running at Swift. So it would have been a lot faster here. Like I said, if I got that defense break on the dragon on round 3, just under 2 minutes. Alright. Here's one with the Tark. By the way, here's the Tark. Attack. Crit damage attack. This would help out a lot of different units. 25 speed roll. And here's the Kali. Now, I could either do this with Belusual or with Chilling. I think I might try to do it with Belusual, just to try to keep immunity on. I haven't tried it since I've had him. See how that goes. If not, I'll be bringing Chilling. It's pretty beneficial to all the units that are in there. Kali, because she's generally a low speed unit, everyone likes crit rate. Tark benefits greatly from speed on a skill. And once again, everyone loves crit rate. Just recently made Kali for Guild War sniping. Been hit with it a couple times in RTA. Got a little salty. Me, I'd like to run defensive bruiser comp, so Kali, if Kali makes it, gets one bruiser down pretty much every time she gets to go, so figured it'd be a good idea to join up on that party. Oh boy. No immunity right off the bat. There it is. Beautiful. I don't know how many, I don't know how many hits Kali's gonna be able to take from that dragon, so we gotta push, right? Can we push fast enough? There it is. Mm. 126. Hey, I'll keep that for reappraisal purposes. Here's the runes on the Kali. Attack. Not even done. Need some speed on that rune. Decent rune there. That's the Kali. Quick show. Really lacking on defense and HP right there. But runes I had left over with all the runes I had spread out on everyone else, this is all I could afford. Slowed down my Verdi to make sure that he went last, but also have him going attack rate attack. Further boost that speed team. See where I'm at. On that event really quick. Farmable Dragon B10 team. Yeah. I'll show you. It won't be, you know, your fastest team, but here's an idea. So, if you have Verdi, you can go like this. These are all units you can fuse. These are all units you summon pretty frequently. Couple different options for early on doing Dragon B10. You can do it where you destroy right tower, get rid of the immunity, or you can do it where you go straight for the boss. This team's gonna take a little bit longer, but I mean, time isn't really that big of a deal as long as you get the drop, right? You get the drop, you start getting better runes, you start getting faster, you start progressing. That's what we're after. Runes on Spectra really need some work. I'm running Despair right now on my Sig because it's just what I had left over. Not really use him too much. He's got a lot of use, but I don't use him. Something I can work on. Varro's Violent Nemesis. Let's see, I think Spectre's running Swift Focus, if I'm not mistaken. So remember what I said earlier, once a defense breaks landed on some, your units are going to queue on that. defense break would have been on Dragon right in the get-go. The towers would have been ignored. Would have went straight for the Dragon. Been a while. So if there was something with a AoE defense break, doesn't necessarily have to be like a Galleon, for example. You could use even Lure, you could use a Mantura, you could use, I mean, just anything with an AoE defense break will help speed up your time a little bit. Claw would go well in here. I don't even want to show you my Hua, it's a disaster. Bella's good for the strip. Vero's good for the dot removal. Also adding dots to the boss once you get that strip going. Spectre's kind of your backup damage dealer whenever the defense break is landed and uses a special assault. Considering the dragon has a lot of HP, it'll do a pretty good hit. His skill 3, the backlash, is to also keep the towers from buffing the dragon, as well as keeping the dragon from attacking you. Slows it down, reduces the attack bar, gives you a pretty decent push. So, that's your farmable team. I mean, I'm sure Verdi might not be in that list. I can do it without Verdi if you'd like. There's ways to go around that. You could do it with Sig leader for more HP. You could throw... You want to see it without Verdi? Oh, shit! Pow! Alright, without Verdi. How's it going, pal? Alright, don't have Verdi. What do you got to work with, buddy? Do you have a Chilling? Or a Tark? I think I might want to go with Chilling. Just because it'll kind of speed up your team a little bit more. You do have Chilling. Alright, we'll throw a Chilling in there for you, bud. I mean, you could probably do... Here's mine, just to give you an idea. Like I said, nothing too fancy. Speed. Put a nice speed rune on there. Like I said, I was running crit damage attack for a while. But I put him up to attack HP just to survive a little bit better. Max skills on mine, but not that big a deal. Violent Revenge would be best if you can't somehow get him to go before your team with that rune set and still maintain survivability. Try to do it Swift then. Swift is fine. Revenge would be... preferred, so that whenever you get hit by the dragon, if you fail to pull the immunity prior to that, he'll counterattack and hopefully get it on that counterattack. I've also used Chilling in Necro, use him in Guild Wars, PvP, he's pretty all-around good monster. Lots of different options for him. I mean, you can make him just crazy HP, survive everything, and just be your stripper if you're lacking in stripper in a PvP fight. Kind of build a bruiser comp around that, sustain, bring heals, maintain his survivability while he's letting, basically opening the door for all your attacks. Dragon stage. Ooh, one down. That's alright. Got Chilling, we're good. much different without Averty, right? So Hua would probably go really well in there. It would keep the dragon from laying that last attack in. Keep adding dots on this boss whenever you have Chilling doing his thing. So you could even throw Sigmaris out of the mix. You could put Barrow as the leader, and then you could throw Hua in Sig's spot. Poor man's Verdi, attack bar booster based on crits. I think your best bet is to go the opposite route, and instead of boosting your attack bar, it'd be reducing your opponent's. There's a lot more attack bar reduction than there is attack bar increasing. Most of the attack bar increasing units in this game are single target. Like you have the mermaids with their heal that does a 30%. You have the, it's more so set on reduction. This is gonna be close. Be really close. Got it though. So, yeah, probably a Hua would go a lot better in there. I would take out Sigmaris. Oh, jeez, there it is again. Can we get another? Channel 109. Scroll. Not today. How are we doing on that event? I think I just went through my first stack of energy. That other disappointment scroll, right? Close. None in there. Do a quick necro run, because I just got a mystic scroll. Rotate as I go. Oh, I was messing around trying to use a galleon earlier. Let's see. Normally, I like to run, where is he? This guy. Normally I run that. I was doing, there he is, this one. Like I said, this is my Necro. Tishar, not skilled, needs more HP. That 3000 HP is kind of a bummer. But if you notice, my units, the crit rate, tried to get as close to 67 as possible while giving everybody their subs, speed order, etc. that I needed. I've been trying to work Beth in with it. Not really pumping out the times I like. If you put in Chilling, Tark, Lucian right here, it usually does a bit better, but I figure I'll start it from where I started on this account, as far as Necro goes, and go from there. I've been able to do Necro 10 with a full 5-star team before. I have a post somewhere in the group, probably a year and a half old, where I did it with a 5-star elf, 5-star Elfin Ranger, Fire, 5-star Colleen, 6-star Bella, and I think it was Fire Panda, and who else was it? Oh gosh. Most of them farmable, but yeah, 5 stars. It's all about runes and turn order on this. So what I have going on here, turn order wise, is Colleen, Tishar, Beth, and my two liches. What I want to do, after doing some quick thinking, would be Colleen, Beth, Tishar, Fuko, and then Riggle. The idea behind that is Colleen does the attack bar boost, Beth does defense break, Tashar comes in, wipes it out with skill 3, then here comes the last two liches, if there's anything left over, right? Now, the way that works out on the boss would be Colleen's going to go, she's going to hit 2 to 3 times, Beth's going to hit 1 to 3 times, Tesshra's going to hit 1, and then he's going to have his violent procs, Fuko's going to hit 3 times, and then Riggle's going to hit. You want speed order to be your most damage, high accuracy person to hit last, so you get that attack slow going on the boss, so that you get more turns, and he gets more time for you to hit him. Break him down, right? I haven't landed one slow yet. Tesshra's down. Like I said, he needs that HP, but the speed, or his leader is all I'm using him in here for, aside from the quick early wipes of the floors. I want Riggle to get taken, not Fuko, because Fuko's shield messes up my whole team. Be nice if I got a slow in there. There it is. That's that team. Take that. Try it with a Lucian. This is my good Lucian. This is with a crit leader. Then I'll do one after this with an attack leader. If I get a Mystic Scroll, it's back to Giants. Really wish my Lucian would go before my Tesshar in this team comp. That way he can kill everybody on the first floor with his amputation magic. On the second floor, he would use his second skill, the surprise box, which would almost kill everybody, which would then leave Tesshar open for the easy cleanup. Skill 3, with a refresh on his skill 3 after landing it. Tesshar down, as usual. If I was able to potentially put a speed lead on here, I might be able to get the turn order to go, but it would have to be someone with multi-hit like Lynette, because in that event I would likely take out one of my liches. Really prefer them to do the slow first, but okay. I have Fuko at max skills. I do not have Riggle at max skills. I have Riggle on super high accuracy. He's like 60%. Fuko, I think, is about half that. And all the debuffs. Nope, Lucian's on Fatal. That's why I haven't built up. It's kind of a tanky Lucian. He's got 16k HP. Both my Lucians are steaded up that way. I'm working on farming up Rage Runes. I kind of got an issue where once I figure out one team that goes to work, I like to mess around, and with what I have, I like to see how many other different teams I can do. Like, I've probably come up with an easy 10 teams for doing this dungeon in particular. Let's do the double Lucian comp. Make sure I keep the good Lucian there so I don't forget which one's my bad one right after that. So this is the double Fatals. I think Fatal Energy and Fatal Guard or something, Fatal Shield. Fatal Shield. Farmable N10. Well, on this particular account, I don't have my my Fire Elephant made up yet, but I can walk you through one. If this is the GZ Dragonite. This is the same. Yeah, I can walk you through. You have a chilling. We can fill up and fill that out. I know you got chilling. Do you have a Tark too, buddy? I really like having a Roke built up. I'm actually working on doing one right now. On previous accounts, using a Roke and Necro has been... It's like using a Tarkin Dragons, but it's better for Necro. Okay. Let's see what we can do. Do you have a Ran or Hua from the previous Hall of Heroes? Good. Gotta love those violent turns. Why, yes, alright. So Hua's good. You could probably run something like... Good, good. Do you have Fire Panda? Evolution. Defense break, please. No. Alright, see if I can do this with a team. By the way, all these teams are attack imprisoned soul first and then go for the boss. I don't quite have a team that can just say, screw it, I don't care who you take. Hey, 5-star not skilled is not an issue. Done that before. So I'm actually working on, like I said, building up a bunch of... Hey, you'll get it. RNGesus be with you. So I've thrown Bella in before as an off healer if I didn't have it. Preferably Fire Panda because you get more strikes, but I've done the Bella before. So throw Fire Panda in there. Now, I told you before my Hua was ugly and I'm not going to use her, so I'll show you my ugly Hua. But I'm not going to use her. Oh god, she might be so ugly I don't even have her in my box. Yep. Ugly. Like, random crap. Just runes I'm not using. I get full a lot, so I have to transfer stuff to people. The dupe city right here. Pioneers, monkeys, beast monks. Stuff I'm not using. Alright. He might be alright in there. Now that Hua would probably be the leader. I've got a really lucky monster box, man, but I don't have everything for them to be as good as they could. I don't have the skills. Still farming up runes for them. Trying to get everybody speed synced is kind of a pain in the butt. I just made this a 6-star, just kind of threw runes on it. Do you have one of these, bud? She's great for in here. I'd probably try something like this. Go more survivability. Go on that way, but I think I'm gonna go speed. So, runes on Lynette. Some of them aren't even plussed up. Skills, not maxed. Barely a 6-star. Oh, excuse me. Well. Party. little scary on the hills. Chilling, doing lots of work in here. So, the dark, magic knight, the panda, those are your defense breakers. Panda's one of your slowers, chilling's your slower, primarily. I don't know how well it's going to go with him being my fastest person in here, because generally you want your slower to be your last person, so that they're almost guaranteed to get that slow on the boss, thus enabling all your faster people to get the hits on after the shield is broken. Unfortunately, killed both the units on the side prior to killing him, therefore his attack gets boofed up from this passive. Kinda sucks. But it looks like we're able to sustain. Seen people use units like Theo and Necro. I don't much care for that. It's kind of harder to kill. Gotta kill him, gotta pop that Endure. Usually people that build a Theo build one that lays does pretty good damage. He ignores element, so whoever he hits on your team, if he's taken over, he gets screwed over. I suppose it's a high risk, high reward trade-off if you can somehow get it to where he's not taken. But his hit counter's not necessarily too high either. It's a 1 and 3. And that Tark guy hit pretty good on the last attack. Since you don't, you can't increase attack bar, anything that increases your attack speed or lowers theirs is very beneficial in this dungeon. That's why the slow is number 1. Defense break is number 2. After that, it goes anti-heal and attack break. Boss is going to heal up every attack. Now, Lynette's skill 3 does damage based on his HP, so having that defense break, the HP, and getting a crit in, do some pretty good damage, even though her crit damage rune itself isn't powered up all the way. Luckily, I don't really have two gnarly runes, but her skill 3 is enough to make the boss aggro on her, because it did the most damage. So whenever she gets taken, it's an easy yank back over to my side of the fence, right? Got the slowed, here's the defense break. Tark comes in, capitalizes. Chilling should have just attacked, but we got it. That's your farmable, minus the chilling in the dark. Check that event. Ooh, scroll. Come on, lightning. Papa needs a fang in. Nope. Second Tark, but I already have too many units that require runes right now, so I'm not really worried about it. Let's keep this a little bit, just get another one of those. Only one awake in my house, unfortunately. So that defense break went to the middle guy first, but alright. Farm dungeons all the time. I actually have a buddy who helps me farm while I'm at work. But I farm all the time. There's never a point where your runes are good enough. Even some of the top people are still farming. top is as high as you let it go, right? Keep pushing that up. Oh, that's a wipe. No defense break. There's no way Lucian's gonna get that with no turn bar. You can throw Sierra, you can throw Charlotte, you can throw Ganymede. You can throw Molly in for safety. Even though he's on Violent and he kind of makes the boss upset because he hits more than once, he's at least putting the dots in whenever he gets that hit. Excuse me. I like that he puts the slow on the towers on the outside. He does things like that, clears a way for me with the Violent runes. Which leaves my... Notice that Teshar got the hit on skill 3, got a kill, which means it's still open. Say we do some guild wars after this. Good runes are based on what your team has, what your monster box is looking like. For me, I need speed runes. So I'm gonna accept runes based on the amount of speed that they have. On the main stat, if it's an attack rune with speed, HP rune with speed, defense rune with speed. Runes like this are purple, means that I have a higher chance of increasing my crit rate by a substantial amount. The crit rate being at 5%, that's a pretty decent roll. I think it goes up to 6 or 7. So a rune like this I might keep just to see if it goes on crit rate. Unfortunately, there's not a lot of other stuff I really want to work with. Accuracy might go alright for something like Siege. Something that has a negative effect on it. So this rune I'll just keep it just to see what happens. But generally I keep it based on what it has in the subs since they introduced the reappraisal stones. I've been more willing to keep runes that are 6-star, like an HP percent rune, that I feel like I can just re-roll later if that's something I'm desperately needing. I mean, you can get 3 a week from farming. The Rift Raids, go in here, special, and you can make 3 of those. I've already done it, so unfortunately that's not an option for me at this time. That better not be a Canela. Salt. Alright, Guild Wars. So I'm going to do a 3-2-1, depending on the color of my opponents, like this 3 yellow right here, I'm probably not going to hit. I'm more likely to hit this guy right here at the end, because no one's touched him. Pretty solid defense. Seems like it's doing okay. He's doing stronger earlier on. High level issues, did alright. So, seems like it's a decent defense. Let's see what else we got on the +3 side. G2 player. Huh. Camilla, Rocky, Tiana, huh? Juno, Pathfinder. Okay, so the strategy on team 1, I think, is to remove everything. I think is Rocky's going to go first. After that, then it's going to go skill 2, defense break. Camilla's going to come in and hopefully wipe. Team like that, probably want to use something with some sustain. It's going to be able to out-heal, take on a Camilla. I feel like I'll be able to kill a Rocky. And a Tiana, no problem. It's Camilla's sustainability that I'll have to worry about, dragging on the fight and pushing me down. Yeah, all girls team indeed. I could try to run with any sort of little strategy you guys want. If you guys want to see me do match elements, if you guys want to see me do match monsters if I got them, if you guys want to see all boys, all girls, let me know. See what we got. Let's check out this number one guy. Common defenses nowadays, the Cummins Theo Orion. Cummins Theo, anything really. I've seen it a lot with Hua. Galleon Hua and Usa, okay. Varad Praha Ritesh, Zingzei Theo, okay. So for plus one, it looks like I'm looking at those two. Which one are you guys having more trouble with? Something like that? Something like that. Sustain. Damage sustain. This one hasn't been hit. We'll try this one. How's he doing? He's doing all right. Has some issues, but he's doing okay. All right. So we got Varad, Praha, Ritesh. I'm assuming his turn order is going to be Praha, Ritesh, Varad. Or Praha, Varad, Ritesh. He's probably going for a strip, attack bar reduce, defense break, or a strip, defense break. Attack bar reduce would be more efficient, getting more damage out of that Varad when he's doing his skills. So what I'm going to want is I'm going to want to be able to put my immunity on after the Praha. So if I were able to throw something like my Wusa, get hit by Praha, still be faster than Varad, still be able to throw his thing if he's not already faster than their Praha. I have a feeling he just might be. It's okay. I can probably take one turn. I think I'm gonna go. Keep Varad immunity right there. Gonna want a defense break if I can. Go in there. Is nothing too special. It's really lacking in damage. Just wanted to keep his HP up there. Here's the Wusa. Swift will. Just kinda. Okay. Nothing too fancy. Yeah, it probably could be Lucian. My Lucian needs work. If their Praha's running Nemesis, that could be an issue. I'd likely need, he's running an HP leader, Ritesh generally.
So free pass for my Ritesh.
It's got about 24.5, so put the halves together, call it 25 plus 13, that's 38k plus 33. On his 13, there's going to be another 4, so it's about 42k. I need to be able to throw a pretty decent amount of damage with my cards. So, with that crit rate, I need to ignore. Yeah, the Nemesis is a big issue nowadays, right? So I could go and try to Theo Chess on it. I could. So what's he got on that team? I think I'll try that. Why not, right? It's gonna be iffy. But I think I can get it. I'm gonna have to try to go for his, I think I'm gonna go for his Varad first, just to keep his crowd control off. Team 2, it's gonna go Varad, Team 1 will be Varad, Ritesh, Praha turn order is what I'm gonna go for as kills go. Team 2, he's got lots of crit. Crit's my favorite. I have the anti-crit team. Where it at? I'm gonna throw a rotation there for a defense break. And just because. Ragdoll's very slow. I have him running a HP crit damage defense build.
Sure, it rains after the fact. So here's what I'm kind of worried about, right? If I pop my immunity right now, which I'm going to do, even though Praha's probably going to take it off, I'm kind of banking on a derp or an accuracy fail right here. There's the derp. All right. I want to save my defense break for that Varad if I can. Put this on for the attack boost. Beautiful. Can I sleep her? If it happened after that, that's okay. The revenge. Gotta love that. He's gone. I thought he was. Son, no proc. Close, very close. I wonder if he's running revenge. Let's find out. Now I gotta get this defense break. Got it. Glancing hit on Ritesh is great. Stops his ability to get that crit, get that speed boost. And right here, it's smooth sailing. Let's keep that on. She just used her that. It's going to be a little annoying. She's out of heals now. Could have saved that for whenever the defense break went off, but push damage. Alright, round two. Strategy here is I'm going to want to go for the defense break. A lot of these teams use Chasun's on there. I like to try to keep Chasun HP about even with whoever I'm targeting. Since Theo's already hurt, I'm going to go for him, try to pop his bubble. Kind of expecting Xingze to do that, to work on his own bubble himself. There's that. Go ahead and hit me. Nice thing about Artarmiel, the more hits that are crits that affect my team, the more his damage goes up. 20% up to 5 times. I have Artarmiel running defense, crit damage, defense right now, despair, energy. It's a little low on the crit rate, crit damage department. Could use a little bit more HP, but he does his job pretty well. I'm just gonna get rid of that first. Chasun has nobody to heal with. Chasun's no good. Stun? Nope. Violet? Yeah. Now, since he's not getting hit a lot, I figure I'll throw out a torrent. If he was getting targeted, I'd be saving that for him to go down to 30% HP and get the insta-kill. Yeah. As soon as I use it, he gets targeted. How about that? I don't think it'll matter, though. We could auto-battle this one. As soon as I get a defense break, smooth sailing. The plus one. Alright, plus twos. We got this guy. Very annoying defense. The Eladriel with that Kumin Theo comp. Super, super annoying to counter. And Camilla Wusa, that's a bomb team. I would recommend on something like that. For the stripper for this. Turn order is going to go Wusa, Fing in, Camilla. So you'll want to strip them, put the bombs in. hopefully your bombs are enough to drop him. Otherwise, you'll want to reset like a Ganymede, Jameer, something like that. Team 2 he's got going on here. Survivability is trying to outlast you. The idea is pop shield on Mo Long. Get him to use skill 3 and not take a lot of damage. Heal up from the light up icon. If he just so happens to die, the light up icon is going to res him up. Gummon's going to pop a shield and hopefully heal it back up to health before I can do damage on it. I might take that one on. This one looks like it'd be a little bit easier. I'm really a big fan of this kit. It's like the Galleon without the damage boost. It's the turn control Galleon, I like to think of it. That skill right there, very nice. Very nice. This is good for anti-Theos, for anything that works on speed. Stuns are always good, right? So I've always been a huge fan of Lure. Really like Lures. His defense is not doing him very well. Looks like it'd be an easier one of. Alright, plus 2. I think we're going to go this guy. See if I can outbomb it. Alright, bomb team. I need work on runes, so bear with me. Right? Not a lot of accuracy. Needs more damage, needs more HP, needs more speed. That's to remove the buffs. That's to ensure I get turn priority. Also, I can reset my bombs because I'm only going to be able to hit one at a time with this team comp. I could try something like throwing him in there. He's awfully squishy fingin', or Camilla could probably have him in one hit if I'm not able to land exactly what I need to land. I would have to take out Ganymede to throw him in so I can keep my Triton in there to ensure that I get the strip. Too risky. This team right here on the bottom, HP based, if I can throw something like... this... where is she? Where he? Usa. Usa. So this second team I got going right here kind of keeps the survivability up on my team, as my Beth does not have a lot of HP. She's kind of just there for the defense break and the destroy. I'm banking on Wusa as a solo healer. She's kind of iffy, but his main job is the immunity, right? Immunity and that shield. She's there for the defense break. Chao. He needs work. He needs work. But with the amount of heals they have on that team being just the reviver, if I can drop the reviver, I should be able to get the rest of them somewhat easy. I could throw Praha in to remove buffs. I could throw Theo in. I'm probably going to throw Theo in just because he's got the skill ups. And we're going to go for that, I think. There's that immunity like I expected. I had to nerf my my Ganymede. He's really slow now, just so that my Triton could go first, do things like this. That damn Camilla passive though, right? So right here, I'm going to want to take out Feng Yan's skills so that he can't put the heal up. It's also going to keep his attack bar reduced, because if I were to hit him with anything else, it would boost it up, he'd get a turn. Skill 2. Everyone would have a heal going. Unfortunately, with Feng Yan on his team, once I detonate this bomb, he's going to get a little bit of a boost. Didn't even stun the Camilla. That's a shame. Try to stop Feng Yan from using that buff. There it is. And once I put the bomb on Camilla, I have to make sure not to hit Camilla in case I crit, right? Because if I get that crit, then I can't detonate a bomb because she'll take it away with her passive. Goal here is to drop that second bomb. There it is. Hopefully that's enough. That is enough. Now if I can stun the thing in. Nope. Camilla's going to feel the wrath of that. Or, geez, Sierra. Gonna be close, guys. What I really need right now is Ganymede to get some more turns. Ooh, so, option I got here is I could try to throw it to Sierra. If I throw it to Sierra and it works to where Ganymede gets another turn, I can skill 3 on that thing in, reduce attack bar, and then she'll be able to lay her second bomb, guarantee the kill. My other option is I could put the skill on Triton, expecting Sierra to die, reset his skill 3, take it off in case Boos has got it set up. I think we're gonna go to Triton for safety. So I think we might still be able to kill this team with these, just the two. I should have put it on. Damn. Beautiful. Just kidding. The immunity game. Alright. So we're gonna try to strip. Sierra's dead. Oh! So that defense break, they prioritized on the defense break. That gives me one more turn. He's gonna drop the defense break. Everyone's gonna go back to having a... Now they might focus Ganymede. Okay, maybe I can get this to work out in my favor if I work the turns right. So I'm not gonna want to attack Fang Yin. But I can... He doesn't have any skills to use anyway. He's gonna counterattack if I hit him. And... it's done. Keep that damn immunity away. Keep that defense break on Triton for as long as I can. Because if I keep the defense break on him, he's going to keep the target. Sierra with one more bomb. Alright, strip her down. With the comeback, I think we got this. I think we got this. Yeah. Alright. First step, I'm going to try to go for his revive first. It's going to be the biggest threat to my ability to outdo him is going to be his ability to sustain. Even out his HP a little bit. Lots of resistance going on there. Really need that defense break to land. first. Okay, that'll do. Can work with that. I'll work with that too. Oh, so many shields. Since I got his coming HP down, it gave me a little bit of an opening. Alright, there's that opening. It's gonna force that revive skill to come out. Can I get a sleep again? Hey. I'm gonna have to check to see what my Woosa's accuracy is after this. I'm starting to feel like I might have raised some accuracy somehow. Get this coming down. Getting close, getting close. Defense break, that skill should hit. Pulled my fourth boost. Anybody have any ideas what I should do build-wise? I'm thinking I'm going to do this one that I got here, Swift. The second one I got, I was thinking I might do Violent. And what to do about the third and the fourth one, guys? I'm gonna go for that panda. It's the bigger threat damage-wise at this point. Takes away my buff, puts a defense break, makes things that don't normally hit hard, hit kinda hard. That's fine, as long as... kill the panda first. Now I'm going to go back to you. If I get her to sleep, I'm killing Kuman first, but... she's just not taking those defense breaks. Not having it. No skill chow, no attack damage chow. Van D's got the number one chow. Easy runes on that thing. Slow crack at this egg. Defense break, please. Holy shit, we got one. Crazy HP going on there. Just because she has the defense break on right now. There we go. Now we got it. That took forever. You'll take the defense break. Need to level up my Dragon Knights so I get that OP crazy cooldown on skill 2. Use Chow a lot for that that leader skill. A lot of those coming defenses, I like to have my Chow chilling Woosa comp up against that. Plus 3. The only one that hasn't been attacked, let's see if we can get it. Let's see, we got Bastet. Alright, let's see what he's got going on here. So his team one idea is he's trying to go in with Bastet first. Gonna give the attack bar boost, the attack damage boost, the shield. Then he's gonna probably have his Ritesh go second, defense break AoE, Perna go in, clean up the rest. Decent sustain with the Guild War God Ritesh. Many violent turns. Perna's gonna get 10% heals off in the entire team whenever it gets a turn. I think we already took a look earlier. Alright. Team 2's basically gonna try to outdo me. It's gonna outspeed me, is the plan, with that Orion. Then the come and lead. Thea's there to do the damage, getting the damage boost from come and lead skill. So what we're gonna do So we are going to do some sort of removal. I think I'm going to go Angel Team, guys. I think I'm going to go Flusual for immunity. So I don't want that Bastet skill to hit. I think I'm going to go... Tomule. And McKean. McKean is going to be my Perna Eliminator. So that skill. She's also going to boost my Angels with that skill, increasing their damage. Increase my survivability. This team 2 right here. It's going to outspeed me, right? Anything that I know is going to outspeed me, I like to use Omidot for that passive. That's not the best by any means. But whenever they get a turn, it's almost mine, right? That's a Woosa instantly whenever I see Kuma or Kuman and Theo. Instant Woosa for me. And I'm going to pray my damage. It's going to need to be something that can pop through a shield, maybe add a defense break. I might have to panda this one. I'm going to be lacking in damage if I panda this one. Ooh, tough comp. But if I have all will runes, it shouldn't be that big a deal, right? So all will. Gonna go for it. I'm just gonna go for that. I think my that's what we're gonna do. I might be a little bit faster off the gate, but I think I got him in the end. Let's do it. This might be the one I lose today. We'll see. Pretty tricky. There's the defense break. Ooh, no landing. Nice. Holy shit. Perna, calm down. That buff on. If I get a violent proc, that'd be great. Oh, that's great. But it resisted. I'm gonna try to kill Perna first because he's the biggest damage threat. It'd be nice if I actually landed that skill too. From the light sylphid earlier, then it would pretty much be out of the picture by now. Instead, still here. Got lucky that the skill 2 hasn't come out of, Let's make sure that doesn't happen. Threat. Save my skill too. Next one I'm gonna go for is gonna be Ritesh because he's the healer. It's also the defense break, being the biggest threat to my team. He's gotta go. He's got lots of HP, so anything with a dot, throw it on him as soon as I can. They don't have any immunity to take it off, so work with what I got, right? Might actually be able to kill a Bastet by the time Ritesh dies if she keeps critting on me. Ritesh down. That's auto battle GG. That's a skill I've been worried about this whole time. Her one scary skill. those buffs right off. That 75% chance to remove a buff on attack 1. Alright, team 2. It's that speedy team. Oh, violent turns. Gotta love the procs, right? So I'm gonna try to... Shit. It's gonna be rough. I'm gonna go for a freeze on Theo. I can't see. Alright. I'm gonna try to kill that Orion while I have a chance. Nope. Need those skill ups. Need those skill ups. Orion's down. Luckily for me, I still have Kumin with that, the lowest HP right now. Alright. Here's where I think I lose. Yep. There's no winning that. YOLO. Well, can't win them all, right? Probably should have went in with that Amu Dot. Probably should have had Amu Dot on there. Make my team go a lot more often. I put up a, salt defense for this week. Just kind of going. I think I changed it right about here. Guild Wars. I got 34 energy. Let's burn through these extra 3. Where are we at? Alright. Damn. Heavy fire team. I'm gonna wanna strip. Gonna wanna kill that Huadam. Strip. Huadam. This one right here? You really want that thing any bigger? Better? It doesn't have any strippers. Kind of banking on Tess to do my heavy work for me. Gonna wanna kill Huadam. You know what? Just for the sake. Yeah. So my idea here is I'm feeling like I'm gonna get crit a lot. Rakan's gonna crit on me. So I'm kinda hoping that Artamiel's gonna jump in whenever I'm getting the crits on. He's gonna start taking off the Volusual buffs on them. It's gonna make it a little bit easier for me to get to that Huadam. Start off with a visual's gonna go first, so I want you to skill 2. Start working him. Gonna resist. Oh, visual derped. Visual derped. Let's see if we can work with that. Oh, so close. Try again. Thank you.
is a violent energy. Speed, HP, defense, I think. Gotta go for the Rakan next because it's gonna be what Chasson's
healing off of. If I can get rid of him, it's easy for the rest of the fight. I got a lot of OP units, I don't have a lot of OP runes, I don't have a double mon stash. Even with, I mean, I'm missing 22 nat 5s that aren't light and dark, so I know I have a lot of units, right? But what I don't have is I don't have a lot of runes, I don't have a lot of the skill ups. So, I mean, you can do a lot of things with a lot of units, but unless you have the skills in those runes, it don't really matter, man. Yeah, unfortunately, yeah. This is a fun little hobby of mine. So I've put some cash in a Comtuos's pocket. Let's see if we got a Rakan. Stripper, speed booster, and HP boost. So team like this, I'm going to want to kill Chow first because he's going to do more damage based on how many people I kill. So I'm probably going to want to go Chow, then I'm going to go Bernard because he's got a defense break, then Rakan. Chew will be easy at the end. Camera's awfully big now. It's in the way of all the buttons. Speed boost, here comes the stripper. No strip, he derped. Rakan's already got Will on. I do have Amelia. She's awesome. Unfortunately, without her skills being maxed out, man, I don't really mess with her too much. I threw some runes on her. I nerfed her a little bit once I got Ariel last week. I pulled a lot of my Will runes, a lot of my Violent runes that had speed and HP off, put them on him. I'm a huge Archangel guy, so as soon as I pulled an Archangel, I got a little giddy. Instantly started yanking runes off of people. There I can. Yikes. So, yeah, I got her. She's awesome. She's really annoying in RTA. She's got a great kit. Until she's max skilled, though, she's kind of iffy. In my opinion. Kind of iffy. Right, goodbye, Chow. Like I said, I'm going to go for that Bernard. Doing work on that Perna though. Beautiful. Strip that Rakan. Not today. Could probably. Now, nice thing about Water Panda, anytime you have any sort of shield, you can use the skill 3 without feeling the full lash of his HP drain. So, like right here with the Wusa shield, I only lost that much to do all the damage I did. If you use something like a Chloe shield, like a light, Undyne, etc., Neil, the light fairy, put invincibility on there, you won't lose any HP. Buddy of mine showed me a video that Vandy put out, or not Vandy, YD, I believe it was, for his using the new light paladin. He's immunity from that, using the panda. Thank you.
building.
Okay, we got Triton. Fangyan is like my number one nemesis, man. I don't like the thing with Fangyan.
So right off the top, I'm thinking bombs. Fangyan and Camilla, those two warrant bombs.
I'm thinking he's gonna try to strip. I'm not sure what his plan is there. He doesn't really have anything to slow me down. It looks like he's just going for the sustain. I should be able to bomb it. Here's the runes I'm working with. Low accuracy, no will runes, very squishy. I nerfed the hell out of Ganymede so that he'd be slower than all my bombers. Triton's super defense needs way more speed. Needs more accuracy. But I think it's enough. Let's go for it. If I can get rid of Camilla and Fang Yan, that would make life a little bit easier. Unfortunately, Tess is one of those monsters that can kind of surprise you. There's a lot of build options for it. You could be running a crit damage, you could be running a crazy speed attack build. That's the way everything is looking right here. I'm going to go for the silence. Got it. And from there, I can either... Oh, I know that Fang Yan's going to want to clear out the bombs that I put on him once I use my light bomber. So I'm gonna go Fang Yan, skill 3. Remove his cleanse, his self cleanse. Reduce the attack bar, hopefully. Alright, not bad. Now I'm gonna save this, this skill 2 for whenever I get my bombs all deployed. Out the way. That hit. Okay, I'm gonna go 2 on Camilla. There we go. The beauty of the light bomber, I can crowd control, reduce attack bar again. Reduce attack bar again. Reset the bomber. I mean, in this case, I could reset Sierra for speed purposes. I don't really think that there's a chance anything's gonna happen there. Although both my bombs did resist, so I guess not too bad. That. Oh, okay. There we go. Oh, jeez. This thing is difficult. Yes, I'm on the global server. Alright. This guy, after his buff, has been quite a challenge. Invincible. So I'm gonna wanna one-shot this guy.
You're gonna wanna one-shot him. I have to worry about revives. I have to worry about damage mitigation. I have to worry about insta-heals. So, I'm probably... if I'm going for a one-shot kill, it's either this team, or I could try that. But I have to... Oh, man. I only get one shot. Let's try the Zyros team.
Might fail. Beauty in the Zyros being there, it'll stop the revive skill, hopefully. It'll stop, Chasun from doing insta heals. I mean, it could be an advantage, but without my double bomb reset, I might be hurting too. Luckily, I don't have any immunity to work with. So I'm going to go for skill block, which I think we failed. Galleon, somewhat failing. Got that defense break. Alright, now if I put the bomb here, I really need Zyros to go first, kind of. But if I put the bomb here, he's going to get that shield, right? So I'm going to go... I was going to go for that reviver. Looks like that's now happening. He will die here, though. I don't think this is enough to kill the Hellfest. Oh, so close. Luckily, I was able to manage to heal up a crazy amount right there. Alright, so here we have a super speedy bomb team, right? Anything that outspeeds? Dark Horse. Always the Dark Horse. Now they're gonna have buffs going. He's gonna come out, he's gonna go in.
Reason for that being everyone else here has immunity on, so I'm not really too worried about Sierra. The only thing that's really gonna hurt me is if Sierra on my side gets the immunity removed, or that Orion goes. That'll leave my Sierra
open for a bomb. It's pretty much a bomb fight here. Whoever can throw a bomb first. Malaka's got bombs too, so if they ruin their, they ruin them all right, then Malaka's gonna go before the Sierra. It should go to an order of Orion, Megan, Malaka, Sierra versus me. There's Orion, here comes Megan. Then Malaka's fast. Malaka is fast. Ganymede is dead. Take all those beautiful buffs off, weaken that team. Go for Sierra first. If Malaka somehow were able to get his debuffs off, I could at least pull one of them off on Triton, throw it back at him, kind of use that to my advantage as best I can. It's a really nice feature of the Sea Emperors. It's that negative effect pass off. Right here, I can throw it to him. Just throw a bomb there just cause. That bubble is so big. Get Malaka out of the way. Bombs for everyone. Going to attack. I'm assuming he's got Will on most of those units. You know what? Let's see. See what Zyros does. Zyros and Zyros. He's going for a damage. He's banking on Amudat to pretty much give him the turn. Based on my speed, I think I might be slower than everyone.
My turn order is Triton, Zyros, Ganymede, Amudat. Let's see how it goes. I'm going to try to reset his Zyros skills. I'm going to try to
reset his Theo cooldown. So even though he has the elemental advantage right here, I might be able to
get lucky, get a stun maybe if RNG's on my time or on my side. Okay, let's go for the strip. On that Amudat, that's kind of nice. We're gonna skill reset on Theo, guarantee that he's not gonna come back if he dies. Go for this gun. Stop the Zyros from being in here. Yep. Stop everyone else from here. Beautiful.
Run his dot skill out there. Would have been alright. Could have saved that game lead skill for the next turn.
Drop the dots. I'd like to try to keep Chessen's HP about even, so whenever she Bomb Blossoms, that's not a Big move, if any at all. Probably drop it right here at this point.
Alright. 9 wings left. Let's burn them up. Make sure you heard me. Yes, I'm on the global server. Alright. HP leader. Got an Orion. It's going to speed me out. So I'm going to bring on Udot. Zyros is anti-Perna. If I can, I think this would be usable. So the idea I'm going to use here, if his Volusia goes off, puts that immunity out, I'm hopefully going to be able to hit it with Triton, take it off. Galleon would have worked pretty well in this offense team too, would have making it pretty quick. Less chance for him to hit me back. No, you know what, to be honest, I generally, like, I'll show you my arena history. I don't normally do a lot of arenas. I just started doing it, maybe, to help out some people. I mean, I'm using teams that maybe not everybody has, but they can still use my strategies with the teams as an idea to figure out what they want to do to counter certain monsters. But I put in, like, I don't know, 30, I think the highest I've ever put in is, like, 150 attacks throughout an entire week. I'm going to reset on Ganymede here just so I can control who uses what skill when. I'm going to keep him down. I'm going to keep you down. I'm going to work that Perna. So he's our threat. Threat gone. Don't have any buffs to use right now, but I use that to drop their attack bar. Use this on Zyros. Keep the dots coming. Next time Zyros gets a turn, I'll reset skills again. Yanny is my absolute favorite monster. I've done more spending on this game trying to get Ganymede than on anything else. Crazy amounts for that Ganymede right there. I summoned 19 Nat 5s hoping to get Ganymede before I got Ganymede. I put in over 2k stones on the last Ganymede week, didn't get Ganymede. Went into a rage, spent more money than I probably should have.
Got one of those $100 packs after I went through like 2,100 stones, failing every time on stuff. You know, I got lightning duplicates at 4 stars
like 3 different times. Scam stones was happening, I was getting scammed. Went through 44 Mystic Scrolls on my 45th Mystic Scroll, Ganymede, on the last day of it. It was beautiful. So stoked. So this team here, FaZe, a huge, huge threat. I don't necessarily want to use Zyros on FaZe because if I put her skill 3 on cooldown, it's going to mean that whenever she gets hit, she's going to pop it on me. I got a couple options. Really what I'm going to want to do is I'm just going to want to ensure that I go before that Faye and I'm able to hopefully take her out prior. I could go in with a bruiser comp, I could go in with some sort of strip, like whether it's Triton or if I'm going bruiser, I could go, I can angel it, I could run along Woosa. This guy, even though I haven't skilled him up, he's become, since that latest buff, man, he's really, really doing a good job in there. For the buddy with the water unicorn, here's mine. Like I said, she went through some nerf. I had her at, I think it was like 99 speed, violent nemesis. Runes aren't done. Need work. Kind of low subs.
for more in-game kind of thing. Like 8 and 6 is not in-game by any means. 10's pretty low, 14's kind of mid.
I kind of like having these two together. The Panda and Beta, who we recently just pulled. Beta's there for the revive. Crit resist will be nice. But the revive and immunity addition, so whatever my whenever my Woos immunity's up, I can bank on her immunity to kind of be there as like a fallback plan. If I end up having to go a little too crazy on that. That Faye. I could always revive him if I have to sacrifice him to get that kill. Very strong defense over here. I really needed that strip to happen. Since I didn't get that strip to happen, I know I have immunity, but Faye's gonna go. And I'm gonna crit resist. But ignore defense hurts. Now she's got it on cooldown, which means she can hit me with it. One more time. There it is. Could use a skill 3, but I want to get her down about 30% HP before I drop it. Being 70% of their max HP if I have it. So I'm going to try to work that Fae down first. Be a lot easier once, Am I going to lose Amidot here? Is that going to happen? Oh, man. My out-teamed here. Yeah, probably should have taken Triton. It's going to be a close one. Alright. I'm not going to want to hit Rakan, so I'm just going to go for her. Defense break. But this survived, look at that. It's just hanging on by a hair. There it is. It's alright, we lined up the shot. Lined up the shot. Next target. Next target. I think I'm gonna go for Lucy. Now, if I time this right, and I'm able to revive my Amidot at a time when Rakan's not going to go crazy and hit him, I might be able to get Amidot back in the game if one of them's still alive. And he's back. Stun? Yeah. Where's that quick heal? Yay! Do some work real quick while he's sleeping. Sleep. I need that skin on my Woosa. I need it. Remove. I probably could skill 3. I have a feeling Cheslin's gonna make it to where I really should have using that skill 3. Let's hope not. Let's get a stun on her. Nope. Yep, there it is. Damn it. Dark Horus is there for turn control, attack bar reduction, and speed. So his passive, he gets 25% every time they get a turn. This drains their attack bar, and then also decreases their speed. This one lowers their attack bar too. But then there on Despair, just kind of controls a little bit of the, what the team's doing. This is the turn that the Woos is going to die. And now we're going to work on this. Both Libra can. One of the 22 Night Clouds I don't have yet. Beautiful stun right there by Mellow Long. Stopped a lot of those revenges. Healing back up so we can do more damage with that skill 3 whenever it comes back around. Keep working that. Stun. On slower units like Rakan, it's really nice actually having a someone who reduces attack turn.
I'm gonna go for another stun.
But it's nice to kind of control the turn a little bit. I don't have a Varad. The only other thing I really have for deterring turns would be be gaining mead. And the way I have him ruined up right now, it's not necessarily for speed, so it doesn't do as much as it could. Can down.
My long trick number one, 70% HP is insta kill. Just kind of repeat that process if need be. Healing up, she's not going to do much. HP base damage on skill 2. Yep. Go to sleep maybe. She's only going to be able to heal about 20%. I have 2 more turns to like release my HP nuke, so I guess it's not going to matter. She should be dead by that time, hopefully.
Okay, revive, immunity stealing via Ethna, attack boost, defense breaks there via Ethna too. So he's got a decent team here. He's got his healers are covered, his damage dealers covered with that Eladriel lead. He's got immunity from Blue Jewel, he's got defense break AoE from his damage dealer, decent sustain, so I'm going to want to control turns, control skills, might try this team right here, assuming I'm going to go first, that is, see what happens. If it works the way I want it to, it should be Triton, Galleon, Zyros, Sierra to clean up whatever's left over. Is there anything in particular you guys would like to see? I can show you guys my monster box. You guys can try to see certain... Ooh. Smack. Show you guys certain compositions. If I have it, what I can recommend, if I have it, etc. Right here, the Volusia is going to go. I'm going to want to just get rid of this if I can. If I can get rid of that before Vela, it's going to be hard without that defense break, but at least I got the skill cooldown. Here, I'll stop skills since Vela derped. Violent procs.
I think this is a loss, guys.
Isabella's gonna remove all that.
Oh, and this one. There's no women.
Done.
Really? Look at that. What a hero. Blue Eladriel saved the day.
Or Eladriel saving the day. Might have won me the fight. Ooh, I don't have a detonate. He might be able to take that off on his next turn. I was hoping for a stun there, not gonna lie. I was really hoping for that stun. There's no winning that. I have to come in with a more of a bruiser comp on this team. Pretty well-rounded defense here. Probably Lucian it. Alright, let's Lucian it. There's no one in that. I never really use a Lucian team, so let's see how it goes. Yeah, see? I'm gonna throw Alicia just for arena damage. She's not really gonna do too much in here considering A, the lack of runes and skills, and B, fighting wind. Lots of wind.
I could go with an attack power booster.
Big guns. There's an immunity I didn't want. One Lucian stunned. It's gonna hurt my top. Oh, really? Violent procking me? Really? Stun, boy. Nope. Try some violent proc for the win! I have no HP on slot 6 on that galleon, so he dies pretty quick. Damn, try some violent proc got me! From Galleon. That violent proc. That violent proc, though. Nope. Okay, we'll try a little alternate team. We'll go Sierra. Kali, Gally, alright, my Bernard I don't have, don't necessarily have set up entirely, missing a rune right there. Where is he? Gally, sorry not Gally and Triton. So the idea behind this team right here is I'm going to have the speed lead, I'm going to go first with my Orion, hopefully I'm going to stop somebody from using a skill, I'm going to come back, attack boost, kill one guy, move on to the next one. So if I can get this to work on that bubble, on the usual, it's not. Let's go for that now then. No, I'm gonna go for the stun.
of Eludrill. Because I'm going to expect Kali to get the kill on Eladriel. Drop that. I have crit damage on him, so I'm just going to go with it. Stop the skills. That's okay that he got the heal. We're going to work on you. Let's throw another one back on our buddy over here. I think he landed. No, yeah. Another turn? Bye-bye? Oh, no bye-bye. I'm expecting him to do that. Really low HP should be a simple kill. Now, even if I put the bomb, should be able to kill Eladriel with that bomb detonation. Apparently I was mistaken. Get out of here. Stun. Go for those extra turns. He's not been producing for me. Chasun. He's Chasun. Just get out of here. Yeah, pretty solid defense. I've hit it with quite a few different things. A couple options at this point would be go for the nuke on... Oh, that sucks. Go for the nuke on Chasun, maybe. Get rid of her early on. I think I'm going to go like this. I'm going to try to get my Triton to get his skill up. There it is. It'll be ready next turn. Alright. Alright, here. I'm going to get rid of you. I'm going to get rid of that. She's dead. That's going to come down to a last second. Last second clutch Kali win. If the turns are right, she might have her Fallen Blossoms. GZ Dragon Daywatch. Put this up. The Violent Chasun returns. Like, really returns. Glancing hit. Now, the nice thing is he just gave me a defense break on my next turn. I get rid of the damage. Use the defense break. Didn't land, but the thought was there. The thought that counts, right? Silence. It's going to keep attacking my wind attribute. Now, as long as I can keep that tower, should be alright. Should be able to get him. Should be able. Thank you. We beat him, finally. That is one hell of a defense. Where's my Eladriel come to us? I need that angel now. Alright. Yeah. Thank God for that fucking low-level sniper. Build you guys a Kali. Got all these nat 5s, but Kali came in clutch. Right here, gonna wanna have an immunity-based team. Something that's not relying on me to go first with like a Bernard or a Orion because he has that Leo there. Yep, get that Kali built. Hurry up. So I'm gonna throw Wusa. It's my go-to immunity until I get my Eludrill skilled up. There he is. Something with a defense break. I'm going to go Ritesh for the sake of the element we got against us here, being wind and water. If I want everybody to do more damage, I can scale with HP. She would be good, except for this is a wind team. Still a wind team. I could
go speed. I go Sierra. Even though it's going to get nullified, she's immune. Oh, here we go. Beautiful. Chins to use segment. And, my favorite. The one thing I'm going to have to worry about on this team comp is Leo. Leo. Got skill 2 ignore. I can't let him, use his Tauren on me. My turn order is normally Wusa, but since he's crit happy, he's been getting hit. I tried to stun on that Varad, no dice. Now here, I can go for the defense break to lower his damage. Yes, my Archangel is Despair. He's Despair Energy. I'll show the runes after this match. I kind of want to get the defense break early on so the Marotaur Mule can do as much damage as he can. Chesson already got her good skills out of the way just now. Varad's skills are going to have no effect. So that skill 3 on my Desert Queen I can save. For Leo, if he ends up getting too low HP, I can use it on Chesson to make sure she doesn't get that clutch heal like I was getting hit with in those last few games. That's what I'm going to do. Could heal, but go for the kill. There's the kill. Bank on Ritesh for that heal. Woo! That was close. That was close. Alright, maybe I won't bank on Ritesh for that heal. Let's just be safe. Keep you off of him. There's his damage mitigator's gone. Now right here I'm playing risky. He's got enough HP to where he could definitely... Oh, thank you, Violent Ritesh. He would have got an insta-kill on anyone he wanted right there. Auto battle for life. Let's see. Defense with no immunity. Do you have monsters that can strip immunity? You can single target strip with a Bella if it gets that bad. There's other units in the game that strip. They don't have to be, you know, gnats by any means. And of course, gnats have better strips, but there's plenty of them out there. I believe, if I remember right. You wanted to see my Artami? I'll show them to you real quick. That's art, defense, good damage, defense, kind of slow, needs more HP. What I don't do is I don't do enough rating, needs more crit rate, crit damage needs a little love. I would love to have 100% resistance on here, easier said than done. Monsters with strip, I believe. Don't quote me. I believe on the fire side there's this one. Right there. Attacks all decreases if they have beneficial effects. That might help you out. How many more wings? Alright, 4 more wings. I'm gonna take a quick break. Might come back on a bit later, do some... I had a request yesterday for some elemental dungeons. I think it was light and dark, farmable monsters. Do a quick check, see where I'm at on those. Dark. That's the team I used on dark. Here's my light. Need some work. The runes on siege are not up to par. Light's basically single target nukes. Dark is multi-hit nukes. Just a quick, the more you know. Can I hit the battle button? Oh no, it's going to give me two more fights. Alright, so these defenses I personally struggle with. I don't know what it is, but Wind Sylphid, I have issues with. No, I'm not a guild leader. I'm a lowly peasant just like everyone else. I'm a part of this guild. Pretty fun group of guys. I know that there's that one guild that's higher and stronger than the one I'm in. But does me good. But good group of guys. Help each other out. I like to think that I do the same for them. Let's go through these last fights. I think I'm just gonna do, man. Alright, so Shimite is kind of one of those monsters I like to doubt too much, and it costs me a lot. It's one of those cheaper, strong CC nuke units, speed lead for arena. It's a good unit all around. I dislike him personally, so I usually have something a little bit better that I like to use for my teams, for my particular layout. He's going double attack bar booster, so I put in the Armadont. Perna, I'm going to want to do skill counters. So I could do that with Zyros, I could do it with Mihail.
This. I could do it with Sekhmet. I could go Bruiser comp on here. I go like that. I know that he can't one-shot me with that, and I know he can't one-shot a Theo, right? So basically, I'm going in with anti-speed, anti-one-shot, because this team is pretty easy to pick apart. He's got two squishies, damage dealer. Two damage dealers, two squishies. So here, Perna might go off and take out my Sekhmet. No. Yep. No. Jeez. That was a little scary. Now, just so you don't... Oh, this bubble's gotta go, guys. Like, not really a safe spot. Could have healed up Sekhmet, but she did her job. Got my heal out of her. I'm gonna go through his other damage. So it's a threat to my team. The defense break on our Tormeal is a huge shot in the kneecaps. Damage goes down, sustain goes down. Units to scale and defense are great until they get their defense broken. Great for PvP, great for RTA especially. They don't get weaker as the battle goes on. Our Tommyl kind of feels that on both sides, being as passive as an increase on defense whenever there's a crit. Something like that where he gets a defense break on him, it's harmful to him because you build him primarily defense, but it's less harmful to him because he gets that stacking effect. Ooh, alright, this will be a hard one. Right here we got the speed lead with the Don't Kill Me Now passive on Samothe. Kill him, he's going to come back revenge and hurt me. He's got Lyca for the... If more I kill, the more damage he'll do. He's got that crazy speed boost from that dark Dark Captain. It's got the annoying Gemini with the million turns, just like all the other little guys, but he's also got that attack passive. So if his HP is lower than his target's, he's going to do more damage. He's removing beneficial effects. He's doing his skill 2. He's laying defense breaks, which really screws me over. So what I'm going to want here is I'm going to want to go probably a similar comp just to try to keep up with his speed. This right here is gnarly. It's going to increase his attack bar more than most units in the game, as well as giving him a 1 cooldown turn boost. It's going to make Samothe more of a threat. It's going to make that... Yeah, right. There'll be a few losses up in here. So, I'm going to try something. Just bear with me here. My thought process here is he's going to hurt, so I want defense. He's going to crit, which generally I'd want, considering the Ragdoll passive. He's a quick glance at Ragdoll, Destroy Nemesis, or Vampire Nemesis, excuse me. HP, crit damage, HP. I'm lacking speed. Speed is my giant lack here. Everything else is pretty alright, considering I don't have attack on 2, stats are pretty decent. Speed is a huge fail. Now, I think that my game plan is going to be to get multi-hit. So, something with multi-hit that I like to use. It's Fang Yan. We're not Fang Yan no long. Let's get that 3-hit. Yeah, I'm missing Leo and Jaeger as far as Dragonites go, and I'm missing Eladriel and Fermion for Angels. Gotta get them. I think I'm gonna try this team comp. Since I'm gonna try really strong defense right here. Really strong. I think he pretty much stops the Lucian idea with his speed lead, with the Dark Pirate Captain boosting his speed, I mean, unless it derps, but he's got Gemini to come in and put the defense break for Samothe. I'm assuming, yep, here comes the nuke. Alright, survived the nuke, this is good. Now if I can control that Laika from taking down my units, he's going to hit the hardest. Alright, I just want a defense break. Now if I do this... Alright, control that turn a little bit. Put a dot. Get the kill on that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Now, just gotta keep this guy from controlling the turns while getting rid of his Samothe, not sustaining too much damage. Just gonna lay one down on him, that shouldn't kill it. Oh, good. The cooldown, that kinda hurt. I was really hoping to have that cooldown available. Beautiful. Now the crit resist is kind of counterproductive with the Ragdoll passive. I'm kind of just using him right now while that skill's in effect. Whenever it slips through, I get a little bit of a help, but also keep my stuff alive. Yeah, absolutely. I could have skill 3'd with Panda to kill his Pirate Captain, but fuck it, why not? Well, we made it. I was kind of waiting to use Ragdoll skill 2, but it didn't happen.
Alright, last two fights. Let's see if we can pick a couple tough ones. That one's decent. Oh, that one's OP. You want to see that one? That's another good one. That's a really good one. Yeah, I was expecting more out of Laika too. I was able to control his turn a little bit better than I thought. That's an interesting one. Chroma's always fun to kill because she can't be bogged down with any sort of negative effects. I like that picture. I like this guy's photo. Ah, Nico! Hey, bud. Nico, you want to see any of these in particular? I kind of want to fight that one. I don't know how well I'll do. Alright, I want to fight that one. So I'm gonna keep the ragdoll in there for a chroma just in case. You're very cool, Nico, very cool. Vandy tried. Since he has light monsters, we'll put him up there. He's gonna get targeted pretty well. Can I do this with angels? Is this an angel team? Fire and water, or light and Ritesh. Light, Ritesh, left. Inferno would have went pretty well in here too, once I got a defense break. Two healers. One defense break, one immunity on my team. Oh shit. Reinforcements incoming, huh? See how lucky his panda is on the strip. Beautiful. I really want them to keep hitting that ragdoll. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Just keep working on that Molong, if I can. It's pretty solid defense. He's got a lot of heals. Wreck defense. I'm using that salt defense. It's not really there for ultra strategy. It's just there to trigger. Trigger defense. Having the ragdoll in there kind of helps out. Gives me a lot more turns because they have the two light people attacking it. Got a pretty decent crit rate going on, I feel like. So I'm getting a lot more turns. Fuck you, Chosun. Oh, there it is. Hit me. Hit me. Beautiful. I think for the sake of hating her. Oh, no! No, don't you dare violent proc yourself to full health, I swear. Don't you dare. Get out of here. Oh, ragdoll down. Shut up, Nico. Hater. Alright. Got options here. Get rid of this. I probably should have gone for Chosun. What do you think? I want that gun.
Roman's gonna self-kill. Hey, it wouldn't be the first time I've lost. Take a dot. Ah! Nico! Hit auto or no balls? Balls activated. Here we go. Yeah, right. Yeah, that was two fights ago, Nico. Alright, one more fight. And then I'm gonna take a break. What should we do? That one looked kinda good. That one's pretty OP. This one I'll probably lose on. Let's do this one. Finish with a tough one. I'm gonna want a speed lead. Probably gonna want immunity. Ha! Nico, you funny. You so funny. Go yellow? What do you want to see, Nico? What team? I'll let you pick. Still trying to figure out who the creepers are. Lucian that shit? You think I can Lucian that shit? With my crap Lucians? Oh god. This is how we lose points, guys. This right here is how we lose points. We're not even gonna bring... We're not even gonna bring a galleon. No, you know what? We're gonna bring galleon. Probably still won't be able to pop it. Let's pray. Nico Death Trap. Yeah, Nico Death Trap.
You asked for it. You asked for it. You guys are beating me up. Beating me up. Look at that team's gonna stomp on me. Blap. Wrecked. So much wrecked.
I think my kids are gonna feel the pain from this one. Holy shit.
What's the point? What's the point? I mean...
Fucking Nico, no Tiana, get out of here.
Alright, we see where this is going.
That's enough.
Can't take it anymore. My eyes.
Who was that?
It's actually one now.
Click settings, then quit.
Gonna wanna go first. Gonna wanna strip.
Maybe. I don't think that'll sustain it though.
I don't think that will sustain.
Let's go for it. Let's just fucking go for it.
that what you want to see? Alright, there you go. I was gonna bruise it out. Sierra. Zyros. Triton. Galleon? Is that what I saw?
Go, Nico.
Don't give me two losses in a row, Nico. Don't do it. Don't be that guy. Don't be that guy.
Camera's totally over here.
It might be. Just barely, I think. I think it was faster by like one or two speed, which is not right. Agreed. This gives me a chance to drop that guy. No skills. Didn't work anyway. Give me that bar. Get out. No, get out. Win. Nico, made up for your last fail team. Good job, Nico. One wing. God damn it. Let's do it. Going hard for the last wing, guys.
Going real hard. Bolt. What's that, dude? Incoming. Oh, back it up. GG. Hardest fight today. Alright, guys, thanks for watching. I'll be back on later. Might do some more Rift, might do PvP, see what comes up. Troll defense, trolling. So, as I talked about earlier, I've done 185 is the most attacks I've ever done. 55 is C1. Set it, raccoon. Give you a quick look. That's Bolt. See you guys.